70 yards on the ground. That gives him 276 in the game.
It's about the total Ohio State offense, practically. You think he's not something?
24-yard line, third down, 5. Schleister looks at Donley. Throws it short. It's intercepted. Charlie Bauman, the middle guard, intercepted it. Schleister looked into the middle of the short man, and he threw it right in Bauman's hands. The first turnover by Ohio State. And we got a big fight going on. The officials buried in the middle.
Oh, come on now. Quiet down, folks.
Get some more breaking out, so we've got a free-for-all going on down on the field with a dozen or so people involved in it. Schleister threw the ball right smack into Bauman's hands, and I don't know what it was that triggered the fight. He had Donley down the right side relatively open. That number 22, I believe it is, he's shaken up on the play. I don't really think that he was terribly involved in it. 22 is Tuttle. He shouldn't even be out there unless he got clobbered by somebody during the fight.
Apparently, he did not see the interceptor.
Well, the middle guard, Bauman, just simply stood up and dropped back.
Yeah, he dropped off into the zone coverage. I don't know what triggered the action here on the sideline.
There's going to be penalties, obviously, because there are yellow flags all over the field.
I'll tell you, you think the officials don't earn their modest fees with action like this?
Let's go back to the last play and see what we can figure out here. See, Bauman, 58 now. He starts to go in. Now he's going to come back and drop back. And there you see him coming back into the picture. Now he's what amounts to a middle linebacker. And he steps right in front of Ron Strange, the receiver. And he's got the ball.
You see Schleister grab his head when he saw that he did that. Came back in and made the tackle. Let's see what...
And I can't tell there. I don't see anything that would have triggered it except a lot of glum faces.
Yeah, that...
I think your friend Butch Lambert got caught right in the middle of that melee, too. We'll go back to the hotel. We'll see how many patches Butch got on it.
He'll have some bruises. Well, it's an exciting game. It was a big play because even if Ohio State had not thrown an interception, not made the first down, they would have had a field goal opportunity that could have conceivably won the ball game. Now you see the penalty being assessed.
Unsportsmanlike conduct. 15 yards, moves the football to the Ohio State 45-yard line with a minute 59 to play. The Buckeyes now with 69 yards in penalties on 6 flags, and Clemson with 61 yards on 6 calls. And now Clemson with the ball, first down at the Ohio State 45, and they conceivably could run it out right here.
Now Ohio State has 2 timeouts left. They've got to put a stout defense in there and use their timeout judiciously. But the odds are against them right at this stage.
Boy, it has been a whale of a contest. It was Willie Underwood who was shaken up. And they're checking his teeth. Hope he doesn't have a broken jaw. That's a possibility. He was involved in the melee. The gain by the fullback, Tracy Perry, to the 42 for 3 yards. Clock is running. Now we got an official and Woody Hayes involved here. Tom Cousinall, the All-American linebacker, comes across and says to the people on the sideline, "Why don't you guys cool it?"
That's Lambert there.
That's George Hill, kind of standing between Woody and the field. And it's going to be another 15-yard penalty against Ohio State, and that one's thrown against the coach. sportsmanlike conduct. A minute 33 to play in the game, and now the football possessed by Clemson, first down. And it's at the Ohio State 28.
Well, they lost their poise.
Boy, this has been some kind of a contest. My goodness. Inside the fullback, Perry, and he runs it hard inside the 32. Let's see where he's nailed down, about the 26. And the clock is going as we pass 120. Short of the 25. Penalty flags. That's going to be too much time, I think, against the Clemson Tigers. They don't care as long as they can wind that clock off. They lead 17 to 15. They've got exactly 1 minute to play now, and a delay of game penalty of 5 yards.
That's a big penalty because Ohio State does have two timeouts left. If they use them and they hold here, they might have an opportunity to get the ball back.
This obviously will be one of the biggest wins that young Danny Ford will ever have in his coaching career, if his team can hang on.
What a way to start.
Ball is near the 30, second down and 12 for Clemson. And the clock starts to go now as they keep it on the ground and keep it inside with a fullback, and the clock is running now. Time now spent by Ohio State. So the Buckeyes spend another timeout. That means they have one left. One left. Woody losing his composure for a moment on the sidelines, getting a 15-yard penalty flag. Big fist fight on the field between the players. That one cost Ohio State 15 yards. So they've been flagged 30 yards while Clemson has held on to the ball. And now, with a 17-15 lead and only 53 seconds to play, Clemson still has it.
That's the wildest guy I think I've seen for a while.
53 seconds remaining to play. Clemson 17, Ohio State 15. Young Dan Ford, the first game he's ever coached as the head man. Woody Hayes has been at it a long time. It was the veteran who lost his cool and got flagged on the sidelines, cost his team 15. That may have been an academic thing, but whatever, it certainly gave Clemson the football deep in Ohio State territory. The Buckeyes will spend the last time out. Now they have no way of stopping the clock with only 48 seconds to go. Clemson has the football. The down marker, however, says fourth down. So unless Clemson can either pick up the first down and keep possession of the ball, they'll be hard-pressed to run around for 48 seconds and hold on to it. They might very well jack it up and try to go for the 3 points. But whatever, you are sure to see Ohio State people get their hands on that football one more time.
I don't think I would take the risk of kicking a field goal, because if it's blocked, it can be advanced. I think their purpose would be served well enough if they try to run the clock as much as they can, and they're going to have to surrender the ball. The 3 points is not that important here.
What do? Just pitch it wide and run around with it?
Kill some time. Bleed some time off that clock. But don't take any big risk plays. And leave it there for Ohio State to try to go the distance if they can with that limited time available to them.
Here comes Clemson up to the ball, 48 seconds to play. Tigers lead by two. Fuller, going to throw it. And he's got the first down. Threw it to Jerry Butler.
Great call, great call.
Butler spun out of bounds, stopping the clock at 44 seconds, but he got the first down. They have four plays for the ball. Ohio State, no more, time's up, and that should do it.
Yeah, that was a great call, great execution. And there wasn't that big a risk to play. The sideline pattern, although normally speaking, in situations like that, teams will go to a double zone, have a man stationed out in the flat. I don't think they caught Ohio State flat-footed with the play.
And so now it is a matter simply of holding on to the football, winding the clock down in a game that has had just a little bit of everything. We have seen two fine quarterbacks have outstanding nights. Both of them have been absolutely superb. Both defensive teams have played very well. This game, to a large degree, epitomized what the simple art of jousting on a football field is all about. Up to the point where we had a big fist fight on the field, and then Woody Hayes got flagged for grabbing a hold of one of the officials. And there you have it. The game is over. The Clemson Tigers have defeated the Ohio State Buckeyes by a score of 17-15. And the security people now will just double up to try to keep everybody in the stands as the two teams go out into each other's hand, and Woody Hayes is leading. And the official declaration of the flag thrown against Woody Hayes was he was on the playing surface where he's not supposed to be. And I would imagine there were some sharp words exchanged as well, but I wasn't down there to hear them, so I don't know. There's your final score in a whale of a football game, the first meeting ever between these two teams as Clemson wins it 17-15. The outstanding players for the ball game have been named, and they're hardly a surprise. We have two of them, Art Schleister of Ohio State and Steve Fuller of Clemson. It was Fuller's team, number four right there, that came out on top by a score of 17-15. And we had that big fist fight, which cost Ohio State 15 yards for unsportsmanlike conduct. And then you had Woody Hayes get flagged for being on the field, which cost him another 15. And then you had a very daring pass, Fuller to Butler, for a first down that gave them possession and carried them all the way to victory. And the trophy presentation being made right now to the winning team, Clemson.
Understand.
Remember tomorrow on ABC's Wide World of Sports, the Men's Downhill World Cup Skiing Championships, World Sport Acrobatics Championships, and a report on the National 500 Stock Car Race. And so we have wound this one down, haven't we? Final score, Clemson Tigers 17, carrying the trophy off the field, Ohio State 15. Lift provided by the Goodyear Tire and Rubber Company. This has been a presentation of ABC Sports, recognized around the world as the leader in sports television.